Hey everyone, it's Bobby from Lyco Birds with another video in my Bird ID Through the Year series. And as promised, this is a follow-up video to my last one, and this is going to cover female dabbling ducks. And this will include all of these same species we looked at last time with the male plumages, but in a slightly different order so that it makes sense with female plumage identification. First up is wood duck, and these are probably the most distinctive of the species we're going to look at. And you'll see a reminder of the male plumage on the bottom left of all of these species. But you can see on the female wood ducks, they have this sort of droopy crest like the males do, although it's not as prominent. And they also have that same small bill that the males have. And in terms of plumage characteristics, the main thing you're looking for on these is just that amount of white that you can see right around the eye. None of the other species we're going to look at show anywhere near that amount of white around the eye. Next up is mallard, and we talked about female mallards in a previous video, but just as a refresher, female mallards are overall brown and show a dark line through the eye, and they also have a mostly orange bill that can show a variable amount of sort of messy dark. And this is a species you want to be very familiar with and very comfortable with because they serve as the basis of comparison for these other species that we're going to look at. And American black duck should look very familiar because males and females look almost identical. The males have a slightly more yellow bill, like you see on these two examples, and then the females have more of like an olive-colored bill. And to quickly review the plumage details, you can see that same dark line through the eye that you see on female mallard, and overall they look very similar to female mallards, but they are quite a bit darker. And if you happen to see the wing open at all, you might catch a look at the speculum, and you want to make sure there's no white showing here. In mallard you would see white, but in American black ducks you don't. Next let's look at gadwall, and the main things that stand out for me on these are usually the head shape. So you can remember that the male has this very square head shape with sort of rounded corners, and the female has a very similar look where you have this high forehead, sort of a relatively flat top of the head, and again, it's just a very blocky shape. And the other thing that stands out on the head is the bill, which is sort of gray in the middle, and then along the edge, it's sort of orange. A lot of times you'll also see this little white patch here in the wing. So even at a little bit more of a distance, you can see that sort of square head shape and that orange edge to the bill. And if we look at this bird here in the bottom center, I wanted to point out that I'm talking mostly about females in this video, but a lot of the young males or even the males that are molting in the summer look very female-like. And on this one, you can see all of that sort of gray barred pattern that's coming in on the body here that matches up with the male. So this would actually be an immature male that's starting to molt into its adult plumage. And next we have northern pintail, and for these you really want to be focusing on the structure. They do have a pretty dark gray bill and a completely plain face, but the thing that always stands out to me is the very elegant structure. They have this very long neck compared to the other ducks, and they also have these long tails. Now, it's not as long as you see on the males, but the females do have longer tails than most of the other ducks as well. But this head shape and the long neck are the things that really, really are distinctive about this species. To contrast the elegant shape of northern pintail, now we have northern shoveler, which I definitely would not characterize as particularly elegant looking. And on these, I would not worry about the plumage at all. They look almost identical to female mallards. So the thing you're really looking at here is the extremely large bill. Their bills definitely look a bit oversized for the size of the bird. And even at a little bit of a distance, you can just see this silhouette is pretty distinctive. It's almost like someone fused almost an entire second bill at the end of this compared to female mallard. So hopefully you have all of these so far. Remember, American black duck is very dark. Gadwall has sort of a square head with orange at the edge of the bill. Northern pintail has the dark gray bill with plain face and the very elegant shape. And northern shoveler has these extremely large bills. So now we move on to what is probably the most challenging pair of species in this video. And first we'll look at blue-winged teal. And these have dark gray bills, and they also have a sort of faint pale patch here at the base of the bill that sort of echoes the strong white crescent that you see on the male plumage. And we can compare that to green-winged teal, which is a little bit more compact and has just a little bit of a smaller bill. And they also have a little bit of a buffy streak here near the tail. And again, that's sort of an echo from the male plumage. And I think it's probably quite helpful to see these in direct comparison to each other. So again, blue-winged have sort of this pale patch at the base of the bill, whereas green-winged does not really show that. And green-winged has the buffy streak here near the tail, and that's something that blue-winged does not have. The bill shape can also be helpful. You can see on blue-winged, it's not quite straight, but it's a pretty shallow curve here, whereas on green-winged, you have definitely a little bit more of a scoop shape here. And something else that can sometimes help is that blue-winged tend to have a little bit more white around the eyes than green-winged do. So just to review, green-winged is a little bit more compact and has a smaller bill with more of a curve along the top edge of the bill into the forehead. It also has this buffy streak near the tail. In contrast, blue-winged has a bit of a longer bill and less of a curve along the top edge of the bill and forehead. And it also has this white echo of the crescent that you see on the male plumage. And we'll wrap up with one last one that I think is a little bit more distinctive looking. This is American Wigeon. Like the males, the females also have this pretty small gray bill with a black tip. And usually the bill is pointed down a little bit. And the facial pattern of the females is pretty plain, but it does get a little smudgy in this area around the eye. And these definitely stand out as being a little bit more colorful than the other female ducks that we looked at, which are pretty much just brown. These definitely have more of an orangey tone to them. And really, I think of all the species here, this is the one that if you know the male plumage, when you see the female next to it, you just immediately recognize that it's obviously the same species. Although the resemblance isn't quite as strong as American black ducks. So now we have covered male and female dabbling ducks. Next video will be a review quiz on these. So make sure you subscribe to the channel if you don't want to miss that new video. And let me know if there's any concepts here that still aren't completely clear, and maybe I can do follow-up videos with just specific comparisons between two species. But I hope you will join me in my next video. Thanks for watching.